Hello, and welcome to another Let's Play. This is Let's Play Half-Life. This is a game this dude has coerced me into playing because I have not played any of them. I've played Portal and I've played Portal 2. That's it. That's the only Valve things I've played.
Well, we also played Left 4 Dead.
Well, yeah, I guess we play Left 4 Dead.
We need to play Left 4 Dead 2. We didn't finish Left 4 Dead 1. We were on, like, the last episode.
Yeah, we need to do the last episode.
Man.
I forgot Left 4 Dead was actually Valve, to be honest.
Yeah, but I don't remember if the first one was Valve, wasn't it?
Yeah.
They didn't acquire it afterwards. It was the first one.
Yeah, I'm playing Half-Life. There was a Steam summer sale, and it was, like, 99 cents. So I picked it up. I actually have the entire series.
Specifically Half-Life 1, the original, not the remastered.
Yeah, I don't have Black Mesa. It was $20, and I was not willing to spend that much.
I got Black Mesa for free.
Yeah, well, when I can get it for free, let me know. But, yeah, I did pick this up. Let's see. We're trying out a couple new things. Obviously, you can see that we're trying to do something, Camp. It's his birthday. Tell him happy birthday in the comments. He's 18.
It's like an hour and seven minutes into my birthday.
We've already done this intro, so I'm not going to be completely... This is completely blind. I don't know anything about Half-Life.
Well, he does, in fact, know that he dies if you play on hard mode.
Yeah, if you play on hard mode, I die, so I wanted to restart the game.
Insert clip of him dying on hard mode.
I actually might go ahead and upload the first section of the game that I did. But we're going to completely redo this. So if I do, I have the training room episode of me going through and doing the training and to begin with. And now we're trying new things because, yay. But I'm going to be playing in medium because hard was a little too much for me, actually.
Especially for his first time playing a Half-Life game in general.
Oh, yeah. And I'm using a subtitle mod, which should have popped up in the top right of the corner. It should pop up in the top. Yeah, there it is. So thank that guy for the subtitle mod.
You know this guy.
You know this guy, Vit Adn Ammon. Oh well. But yeah, thank him for the subtitle mod because the original game does not have it. Yeah, and thank all those guys too. They
you know
need
what?
It.
While you're at it, look at the credits at the bottom of the screen too. Thank the people who originally made the game.
Yeah, thank John Cook. Thank the loading screen.
All right, just make your own game. Thank yourself. Thank yourself.
Finally finished something, 2018.
You know what, even if you're not working on anything, thank yourself.
Thank yourself.
It's always a good time to thank yourself.
At first I thought you were saying think for yourself, and I was just like, yeah, think for yourself
think
too.
Think for yourself, and think that you're gonna thank yourself.
Yeah. Do it. Oh yeah, and if you see... we have the doggo in the room, and he might appear behind us depending on if he wants to jump up on the bed.
He's asleep at the moment.
He's sleeping.
He's a good doggo.
It's 1 a.m, can you blame him? He's probably pissed off that the light's still on, but yeah. I needed it for the cam.
But we also have
lamp over here, but...
We also have fans and air conditioning, so he's gonna be a happy dog that won't
yes.
die of heat stroke.
He's not gonna die of a heat stroke, so he's getting a 50-50.
He's asleep anyway, so it's not bothering him at the moment.
Gabe Newell, Dave Riler, Riller, Aaron Stackpole, Jay Stelly.
You got stuck on the wall, which stopped the entire train.
Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm guessing that's what just happened.
What even?
It did not stop there last time. Now you've thrown off the entire cutscene.
Yeah.
She's gonna say you're now arriving at the place, and it's not even gonna be near it.
That's weird.
Actually, I think the audio cues are hit by being in the location, so...
We might be saved.
Not by time.
Yeah, there's probably invisible boxes we don't see that once triggered...
Causes the audio cue.
Like, I'm probably gonna go through this door and there's an invisible box right here, around the base. okay? Never mind.
Silence. My favorite audio cue.
Unless she's talking and I just can't hear.
Well, we have subtitles, you know?
Yeah, that is true.
She's talking. The subtitles will tell us.
There she goes.
Gordon Freeman, male, age 27.
Oh yeah, they did fix the text too, so now it appears larger on the screen.
Research associate.
Despite the fact that I'm in 1920 by 1080 window. More lives than your own may depend on your fitness. Clearance level 3. Do you have a friend? Administrative sponsor classified. Addition to the Black Mesa team. Disaster response priority discretionary. Theoretical physics sounds like an interesting choice of major.
Well, it's physics that are
theoretical in nature, as it turns out.
Who knows what they're doing with those physics?
Probably theorizing.
Missing a scheduled urinalysis or radiation checkup is grounds for immediate termination.
He was looking at me funny.
He's adjusting his diet.
I've seen that tie somewhere before.
You're right. It's the same texture used on Scientist Number 43. Should have seen it coming.
I'm just saying, this facility has a lot of the same three people in it.
Yeah, it's an old game quirk and or cloning. I won't confirm nor deny either one.
Definitely saved on model space.
Please stand back from the automated door and wait for the security officer.
Just press your face up against the automated door.
Before exiting the train, be sure to check your area for
it's me.
Do you ever have safe and productive days? Looks like you're running
late. Yeah, 30 minutes late. Security personnel, as it turns out.
What was it, the name tag that told you that, or the fact that at the back of his vest says security?
It was definitely the name tag. Black Mesa Security. His name is
James.
Sunderland.
James Sunderland.
Silent Hill 2 reference, lol. I need to get around to playing that on this channel.
I need to get around to playing that.
You gave up on the lovely hospital.
I had other games on my lineup.
You're playing Dragon Age Origins, finally.
Yeah, and I'm halfway through.
Actually, yeah, you're making good progress. I wouldn't say halfway through yet, but...
I'm in the underground.
Well, seeing as how you can do it in any order, yeah, you're almost at. Once you finish the Deep Roads, which is where he's at, you'll be halfway through. Hello.
Raymond, I had a bunch of messages for you, but we had a system crash about 20 minutes ago, and I'm still trying to find my files. Just one of those days, I guess. They were having some problems down in the test chamber, too, but I think that's all straightened out. They told me to make sure you headed down there as soon as you got into your hazard suit.
So I need to go find my hazard suit. Also, on accident, I found out you could do this.
Hey, what are you doing?
Well, if you look behind the desk, there's a red button that says do not press, that you're accidentally pressing.
I see.
Well, it might not say do not press in the old version, but in the remaster, it definitely says something along the lines of do not press.
Right, right. Okay, so I have to go find my hazard suit.
It's good to see you.
Good to see you too, Frank. Oh, wait.
Hello, Gordon Freeman. It's good to see you.
It's good to see you too. I can interact with the Coke machine. And it restores my health.
Yeah, unfortunately the first game didn't have one of the iconic things that the second game did. which is the gravity gun.
Yeah.
You know how iconic the gravity gun is? It's practically a staple of Half-Life, but it only was used in Half-Life 2. As far as I know. I haven't technically beat Half-Life 1, although I'm at the end of it. So if they would have revealed it, they would have revealed it by now. Some jazzy music.
I feel like I'm playing Doom.
Yeah. With how fast-paced the game is, you'll feel like that with this music on. This music is only playing so that your suit can tell you that everything's online for the only time in the game.
Let me in.
Yeah, we just can't wait for the sixth thing to go wrong.
I can't wait for everything to... It's a good day to die. Do you want to live forever? No.
No. Well, that clearly you didn't, because you died.
No, but like, think about it, alright? Would I want to live forever?
Possibly. I would only want eternal life if I could die at any time. Think about it.
Yeah, I understand that.
You live as long as you want, but you choose when. So whenever you, like, hit the point where you're depressed and or bored of the world, bam, you don't even have to be here anymore. You're gone. If you want to just stick it out and wait till the end of the Earth, billions of years later, and float through space, then you can.
Ah, Gordon, here you are. We just sent the sample down to the test chamber.
We have boosted the anti-mass spectrometer to 105%. Could have gambled, but we need the extra resolution.
The administrator is very concerned that we get a conclusive analysis of today's sample. I gather they went to some lengths to get it.
They're waiting for you, Gordon, in the test chamber.
Okay, alluding to the joke I made originally about how...
Of course not.
How, Rick and Morty thing kinda looks like Rick.
That's a bit of a stretch.
You guys will understand in a minute. In fact, I probably plugged it in, but... What's going on in this place?
They don't even know.
Wow, no! Okay, let's see.
Yeah, back up and... Yeah, there you go. Are you trying to angle yourself first at the perfect angle?
Oh, yeah. I had to make sure I was going in real well.
Well, it would have been dumb if you tried to walk through the door and hit the edge of it, right?
We'll be deviating a bit from standard analysis procedures today, Gordon.
Yeah,
it's Dubois.
This is a rare opportunity
for us.
This is the sample we've seen yet.
A joke most people won't understand. It's from Deep Fear. For the Sega Saturn. I didn't do a Let's Play of it, though.
And you probably never will.
Oh, hell yeah, I will.
Doesn't need to hear all this. She's a highly trained professional.
I am a professional.
Yes, you're right. Gordon, we have complete confidence in you.
That was sarcasm.
Was it sarcasm or a hopeful plea that nothing will go wrong?
Well, regardless, it was false. Let's go! Oh, jeez.
Well, you're doing great running and jumping until a ladder was involved.
Testing?
It happens.
Everything seems to be in order.
So things go while I'm playing Mirror's Edge. Running and jumping until a ladder is involved. Gets you every time.
Rotors, we can bring the anti-mass spectrometer to 80% and hold it there.
Isn't the Stanley Parable also made using Source?
I don't think so. I don't think it was made in the Half-Life engine.
I think it might. Yeah, I think it might have been.
I mean, you could Google it.
I could Google it. But I'm on camera, and that's really unprofessional. Oh dear.
Oh dear.
Phones exist.
I'm on camera, and I'm not wearing pants. Oh no.
Yeah, well, I've been sitting next to you this entire time, but did not know you were not wearing pants. So it's quite concerning.
I'm in shorts. I am a scoundrel in disguise. Heaven forbid this face cam not show.
Gordon, we cannot predict how long the system can operate at this level, nor how long the reading will take. Please work as quickly as you can.
Yep, no, it uses Source.
Oh, okay.
Cool. I thought it might have. So technically, you could thank Valve for Stanley Parable.
And away we go!
Yeah, be careful. Even the pushing on this object, you don't want to slam it in there like you did last time.
Yeah, I guess I'll just gently...
Yeah, just gently, just... Oh, jeez.
Like an angel's kiss.
Oh, dear!
Oh... Oh.
See what you did?
Oh no!
Let
me out of here! Oh
jeez! You've murdered all these people.
Hello, all you people.
They're gonna blame it on you.
Hello, all you people. Let me out of this room.
Ah! And thus, Shodan was born. We'll play System Shock 2 eventually.
Yeah. Probably by the end of the summer.
It's already July.
Whoa! What are you?
Why, you gotta get your shoes wet.
Whoa!
Gross.
Whoa! This is what felt like Rick and Morty. Portals. Unforeseen consequences.
That's definitely like a chapter name.
Oh yeah, definitely. Ooh, let me out, let me out, let me out.
No unauthorized personnel. Is that what that said? Is that the subtitle to this?
Whoa, thank you. Neat. Whoa!
You know, I'm pretty sure this time, last time, you still had 100% health and you couldn't pick up that medkit.
Well, I think it's because I jumped off the ladder a little early.
Right, probably. Also, we clearly saw a ladder for the other elevator, but this one did not have one.
Right.
So people hope that elevator's working, or else they're not getting out, they'll be stranded.
Why didn't they listen? We tried to warn them.
I know, Albert Einstein, it just wouldn't work.
I'm afraid to move him and all our phones are out. Please, get to the surface as soon as you can and let someone know we're stranded down here. You'll need me to activate the retinal scanners. I'm sure the rest of the science team will gladly help you.
Okay.
Have I been that much of a burden?
Let's go.
I think he was following you after that cutscene.
Head crabs.
Yeah, so it's a pretty well-established rule in this universe that if a headcrab latches onto your face,
you turn into
zombie.
A zombie. That's about all I knew about this universe, and I figured that just meant that it was a zombie game. But apparently I was wrong. I was extremely wrong.
There's a lot of things going on in the Half-Life universe. You haven't even seen the Combine yet. Oh boy.
Oh. Hello?
You have to dodge around them.
Come on, bring it. Bring it on. Bring it on. Oh.
Wow, that went about as well. But this was a survival horror game. Lasers are bad. I mean, do you see what it's doing to that wall?
I definitely wouldn't want to be that wall right now.
Bash the door.
I am clicking.
This is unfortunate. Did you accidentally mess up a controller in the menu?
I may have.
You were messing with the controls earlier, so.
Primary attack return?
Edit that.
We'll make that.
And the alternative could be returned.
There we go.
Yeah.
I did it twice. Huh.
It had the same result both times.
As it turns out, that elevator not functioning as it should.
Oh, shit. Man. That's not a good noise.
That is not. Oh, I have a chance to redeem myself. I will not click the elevator.
Do you feel better about yourself?
No.
You didn't click the elevator, though. You could save that man.
I'm gonna save this man!
You see, that's why you can escort people in this game, is that you can save them from enemies and they'll fall around shooting it with you.
Yeah, but it's not mandatory escorts.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
I mean, objectively, you could kill him and steal his gun right now, but I wouldn't.
It's a good day to die.
You're a good person,
if
right?
If you know the view. I got bored during Dagnaropa when the killings were happening. Which,
you're a good person,
which,
right?
Which, Dagnaropa 2. Great game. Oh.
The Dagnaropa series is honestly one of the best.
Yeah, I'm kind of sad that I did not, in fact, play it blind. Well, let's play-wise.
Yeah, because now that you know what's going to happen,
yeah,
doing it.
Since it doesn't change. Like, I can play the No-Nary games, and I can semi-change the route that I take, depending on each playthrough. Dagnaropa, I thought, was going to be something similar, but there's...
It's very static, but also I absolutely love Dagnaropa.
I mean, the thing is, I could replay it, and I could interact with players that I didn't originally interact
but
with.
But let's be honest, you'll interact
I'll have
with the same
to
people.
Do... Well, not all of the same people. I definitely still do Chiaki because that one's interesting to me. And, let's see.
Now, I wonder if those boys could have made a bigger...
I'd probably do some of the people who died first. So I'd try and do
But that would give it away of who's gonna die, like the Monokuma in every person's bedroom. Which I'm kind of angry that the game left such a big clue.
I'm so upset though, because I was one Monokuma doll away, which, assuming no one's played Dagnaropa 2, who's watching
collectible
this,
Monokuma doll.
Collectible Monokuma dolls, kind of like the Monokuma
life.
Coins. And like, I had one left.
You see,
I
don't know
it.
Why you do that.
I did it last time, so I figured I'd show it off again.
Well, you can't let that guy die now that you're helping him.
Well, can I help him escape this way?
No, you can definitely go into the other room as well, but, like, don't let the enemies
Whoa.
Attack him.
He killed him. You're right! That would look lovely. Can I do this?
Nice.
Yeah.
You brought the lights. Maybe you can open that door now.
Ooh, maybe I can help him out? No.
Hey, you can ask him to wait there or something.
Well, can he follow me into this room?
I don't know, I doubt it, but... Not...
No.
The scientists aren't as good as the guards, but, like, the guards can most of the time hold their own.
Okay, yeah, he said he's gonna guard this area. Good for him. I'm gonna love these guards.
But for the majority of the game, you're gonna be wandering about on your own. I do believe that was a decoy. Lol.
I can save him. I can save you!
Smash to the window. No, it's too late.